Okay, so let's take a couple tips that will really jazz up a blues. If we're just in A, D, A, to D. Now there's some chords that we can throw in there, or some scales. We can play around A, just our minor blues scale. Play A diminished over it. Or if I started on the D string on the 4th fret, and I went up to the 7th fret, same string, and then I went to, this is 4th fret, the 7, then I went to 5 on the G string, then the B string, I went 4, then to 7 again on the same string, B, and then 5 on the high E. So that's playing so I can go A, right there alone. It's gonna sound very jazzy. A lot of jazz players are gonna play, and really what it comes from is this diminished chord, which is actually a D flat 9, but the flat 9 is being put up here at the top. So this is a D7. So if we went up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and flatted it, this diminished chord is a D altered. It's just a D7 with the flat 9 put on top. So that's why they get substituted, and that's why we can play that A diminished. Because we're really thinking. Now, so we have A, whatever we're going to play. And I wanted to go up diminished. Now that's gonna sound jazzy. What I just did was, let's take a look at this. We're going here, right? We go to the D, we can play the A diminished, back to A. Now, when it gets to A, we can go A, 2, 3, 4, D, back to 1, 2, 3, 4, then we're gonna go 1, 2, 1, 2. So when you hear this, I'm throwing in, before I get to this, go back to D again, I'm going 1, 2. And I'm playing over it. So now I'm going, but I'm really thinking this chord. But it's gonna fit. Now, this chord, E minor 7, all I'm doing is outlining it. Sometimes I don't have time, so I'll just take these this triad here and go. So I might go. 9, 8, 7, 10, 7. Or I might go 7, 10, 9, 7, 9, 8, 7, 9. And then over the A7, I come down blues. But lots of times, what really gives a nice jazz sound is to walk back in this major scale. I mean, if you go... really just sounds jazzy, because a jazz player would walk right back in A major, right over that. So you outline this two, and walk in major. So you could go, so it's a matter of just hearing it. So you can go. Or come down. Right there, I came down A mixolydian, but, or you can just think A major walking into the A, so, and again, lots of times I don't have time, so you go, so sometimes I'll go, so lots of times I'll, into the blues instead of, I'm going, which is always a great lick, because over the D, instead of playing, you can go and start off this major third and play the same lick. So that right there, I'm just going to stop right there, because those are some ideas. I went up and down it. Just whatever the time, it doesn't really matter where they go. What matters is how much time do I have, because the sound. I stop there or go. There I go. Or only get that far to. It's just you're referencing. And jazz what we call 2-5-1. Go here. So we've got the. anyways, this is leading to this chord. So one more time, I might go. Now I'm starting off this. Back to A. So above that D, man, this is a sweet lick. Especially if you come down like off the this flat five, like the blues scale. Sort of like a over the D. Just sounds off that D. Play off that major third instead. So we'll just stop right there. But so we have A. We know we're gonna get this chord. Sometimes it's hard to outline that whole thing. That's why I'm showing you. You can go. I'd walk down major. Then you're going to go to D. Because that's where these two chords are leading. And then you're going to step off that minor third and go. That's a lot. That's actually, there's so much we can do by mixing kind of jazz and blues. But that right there, you start to throw in you're gonna be really adding. So, let's see. So with the D. As you start putting those elements into your blues, and it is it's a mixture. It's not jazz, it's not blues, it's adding some jazz ideas to pull out some to infuse in with the blues. A jazz and a blues can be a marriage made in heaven, you know, just with finding just when am I going to put this little jazz in here to turn the ear or whatever. Right there, you guys are some really, for those of you who heard that, excuse me, for those of you who didn't, it was a burp. It was, I admit it, it happened. I apologize. That's what I get for having, I think I had a whole pizza earlier myself. It came back to haunt the end of this lesson. But I'm not reshooting it. I'm glad you guys are beautiful, forgiving people. Alright, I'm reshooting the whole thing. Now, you guys, back to what I was saying before, that social faux pas I was saying was, which is really kind of funny now that I look back on it. I hope that you guys can laugh as much as I'm laughing at myself. And, you know, when you start to throw in that diminished scale against that D, that, you know, and you start referencing that 2-5-1, and you go to that, you go to the major third that I probably call the minor third 400 times, because I always call a major third a minor third and a minor third a major third. I don't know why. I bump my head too many times. So, but I do mean, if I said minor third, I meant major third. If I said minor third the whole lesson, I meant major third. For that lick. So 4-7-5-7. If I said minor third to the whole thing, well, if I did it through the whole thing, I'm not going to even upload this. But if I didn't through the whole thing and I did occasionally, I don't know, I'll upload it. But that right there, and we can keep adding. So this is, but you don't want to get overwhelmed. You just want to take some ideas and start to toss them in there. And those are some definite jazz ideas mixing with blues. All right, you guys. As usual, thank you so much for coming by.